Welcome. In this video, we're going to see the latest developments in ANSA regarding the new enhancements for thermal solutions in Pump Crash Deck. Steady state and transient heat transfer analyses are now supported more thoroughly in Pump Crash Deck. Thermal loading conditions for temperature and heat flux definitions are now supported via the related keywords. The capability of handling heat transfer analysis through the related control option has been supported as well. Additionally, some more thermal-related enhancements have taken place regarding various types of entities. A problem of a three-dimensional transient heat transfer with free convection will be showcased. Initially, there is a uniform ambient temperature distribution of 20 degrees of Celsius to all model nodes. Then, at zero time, a constant temperature loading condition is applied on the nodes of the lower area of the manifold where the pipes are connected to the engine. The high temperature of the engine is modeled in that way. At zero time as well, a constant uniform heat convective boundary condition is applied to the solid facets of the outer surface of the pipes in order to simulate the free convection between the manifold and the ambient air. A transient solution is performed for total time of 10 seconds during which heat conduction due to the high temperature of the engine and convection to ambient temperature take place at the same time. Let's see step by step how the aforementioned analysis can be set up in ANSA. The first step is to define the thermal properties of the material. To do so, the user should create a thermal material entity. By accessing the part solid property card and typing a question mark to the ID thermal mat, a new thermal material can be defined. In this analysis, constant values are used for the density, thermal conductivity, and specific heat of an isotropic material. Have in mind to set their values properly, in compliance with the units that are used in the analysis. Solid and hexa element types are used in this case. Continuing with the definition of boundary and loading conditions, a temperature load equals to 500 degrees of Celsius is imposed to the nodes of the inlet base of the pipes through the corresponding set. Moreover, a heat flux exchange surface is applied to the solid facets of the outer surface of the pipes through the corresponding set as well. Constant values for both ambient temperature and heat convection coefficient are used. The initial ambient temperature can be defined either under the heat control option using initial temperature keyword as it will be presented shortly or via the intem function. If both ways are used, the last one supersedes the first. Afterwards, the controls required for the analysis can be set via the control function under auxiliaries group. Firstly, prime control keywords can be defined in the other tab as shown. A total time of 10 seconds is defined for this analysis. Then, the standard control keywords should be set. Starting with the output control keyword, it allows the user to control the solver's output volume and formats. Moving to the time step control keyword, the time step of the analysis can be defined here. A user-imposed time step of 0.5 seconds is used in this case. Next, the implicit analysis general parameters can be in this tab as shown. Finally, heat analysis control is defined using this keyword. An uncoupled type is used for a heat transfer analysis, and the initial temperature of all nodes is set to 20 degrees of Celsius as mentioned previously. A ready-to-run model has been set up. The analysis has been completed. Let's have a look at the results. The nodal temperature distribution can be seen as moving from state to state. As can be noticed, a uniform temperature distribution close to 500 degrees of Celsius cannot be reached throughout the manifold model due to the heat convection that takes place simultaneously during this time. Thank you for watching this video.